Hello children, how are you? So let's begin with a science subject. So today we are going to see chapter number 5, separation of substances. Children, I would like to show you some scientists which are chemists. Van Helmont, who discovered carbon dioxide, Daniel Rutherford, who discovered nitrogen, John Dalton, who discovered atomic theory, and Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who played a very important role in the development of India's missile. So these are some scientists. So let's see what are the objectives of today's topic: to define matter, to classify matter, to define pure substances and mixture, to define homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures, and the need for separation of substances. So before going towards our topic, children, I would like to share some important topics about matter. So matter is anything that occupies space and possesses mass. Examples are food, water, clothes, and everything in the world. You can say that is made up of matter. As discovered by scientists, the matter is made up of very small tiny particles called as atoms. And these particles are so small that we cannot see them with naked eyes. Atom is the smallest unit of which matter is made up of. You can see here in the figure, children, that electrons, protons and neutrons are there in the atom. So you will study in the higher classes. So we have seen about matter. Now it has been observed that matter exists in nature in different forms. Some substances are rigid and have fixed shape like wood, stone, etc. Some substances can flow and take their shape, which is belonging to container, just like water, oil, etc. Well, there are forms of matter that do not have definite shape or size, such as air, many gases. These are the examples of gases. Here you can see in the figure, children, solid. These are made of solid materials, liquid materials and gaseous states they are having. Thus, the matter can be classified into different categories based on the physical properties exhibited by them. The states in which they exist, they are called as states of matter. Here you can see in the figure, solid state, liquid state and gaseous state is there. And the arrangement of atoms are also there. So apart from the above mentioned three, there are two more states of matter which we do not see in our everyday life. They are called as plasma state and Bose-Einstein condensate. Now here you can see the classification of matter. On the basis of physical state, matter is classified into three main types. They are solids, liquids and gases. On the basis of chemical composition, matter is classified into two main types. They are pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances are again of two types. They are elements and compounds. You can see in the flowchart. And again, mixtures are of two types. They are homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. So let's see more about that: elements, compounds, homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. Here you can see, children, the matter is classified into pure substance and mixture. Again, that pure substance is classified into element, compound, and mixture is classified into homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Now, elements cannot be broken down into simpler substances, example copper, oxygen, hydrogen, etc. And compounds have fixed composition and they can be broken down into elements by chemical or electrochemical reactions, example water, sugar, salt, etc. Now let's go towards our homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures. So uniform composition is there in homogeneous mixture, for example sugar plus water, solution of sugar and water, solution of water and alcohol. Now what is meant by heterogeneous mixture? So non-uniform composition is there, and examples are salt and sugar, oil, water and oil, etc. Here in the figure you can see children elements, examples and compound examples. Now very clearly you can see helium atom and oxygen atom. So elements means contains only one kind of atom. You can see here one kind of atom is there. Here even though two atoms are there, but still they are same kind. And the difference in the compounds, you can see two different kinds of atoms are there, hydrogen as well as oxygen. So two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen. So this is compound. Now let's see about homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. So here I would like to show you one activity, and you have to note down your observation in your observation book and watch it carefully. At the end I will ask you some question children, so be careful and watch it. So to see homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture children, I will just add salt into the water. We have just seen the example of homogeneous mixture, that water and salt. So I will just add salt into it and I will stir that. After stirring, you can note down children, in the whole mixture uniform composition is there. So that is homogeneous mixture. You can note down in your notebook. So this is homogeneous mixture. Now let's see about heterogeneous mixture. Here I took here water as well as oil. Oil and water mixture is there. Now I will stir that. After stirring, you can note down children, they are not evenly distributed. Evenly means uniform distribution is not there. So that is oil and water mixture, that is heterogeneous mixture. Now we shall
watch. Now students, we shall watch a video separation of substances. The material that we get that are not always in pure form. Substances occur in the form of a mixture. A mixture is a combination of different substances such that no chemical reactions takes place between them. For example, mixture of food grains and stones. Mixture of sugar and water. Air is also a mixture of different gases. Even the food that we eat is also a mixture. For a specific purpose, we need to separate substances from a mixture. For example, we cannot drink tea as it is. We need to separate tea leaves from its mixture. For obtaining salt, we need to separate it from seawater. Let us understand the purpose for which we need to separate substances. Separation is needed to remove unwanted substances from mixture. For example, water coming to your home contains many impurities such as chemicals, dust particles, microorganisms. Drinking such water could cause health problems. So we need to separate these unwanted substances from water. So water purifiers containing various filters. Second example, food grains often contain stones. These are not useful. So we need to remove them before cooking. Next example, the industrial waste contains various impurities that may cause harm to the organisms living in water. Therefore, impurities must be removed from such water before mixing into the water bodies. Separation is needed to obtain a useful substances from the mixture. For example, iron is obtained from iron ore. The ore contains impurities such as dust and sand, etc. So we need to separate iron particles from the mixture. So that we use magnetic separation. In that, magnetic properties of materials are used. So question I would like to ask for you, that if nails are mixed in dust, how would you separate that? So magnet is used to separate iron nails. Magnet picks up nails from mixture. Students, many a times separation is needed to obtain different useful substances from the mixture. For example, with various separation methods, we get different useful materials from milk. The oil obtained from Earth's crust contains many useful substances such as petrol, diesel, kerosene. With proper separation methods, we can separate all the things which we are getting from oil. That is fractional distillation. So
we will just summarize the topics whichever we have seen today, children. So we define matter and what it is made up of. We can classify matter by physical and chemical methods. We define pure substances and mixtures. We define homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures and the need for separation of substances we have seen, children, today. So this is the summary of the topic whichever we have seen today. So today's moral value. In between human beings, there is also a mixture of many good as well as bad habits. In this video, we have seen mixture and about pure substances. We can separate bad habits and good habits so that we can become a good person, good human being in our life. That is very much important. And correlate all these study topics with your day-to-day life also, children. That is very, very important. So I would like to ask you some questions, children, and you have to note down these answers in your notebook. Define matter, define pure substances and a mixture with one example each. What is meant by elements and compounds? Thank you for watching video.